never lie. Before the world revolved around the sun, God on high stepped down into time and wrote the story of his love for everyone. He has filled our hearts with wonder, so that we always God we receive. Right to life, we open up our eyes to see the majesty and glory of the King. He has filled our hearts with wonder, so that we always remember.
Back home, I went to a non-denominational church, but I never really got connected with other people my age.
I came to Duke as an international student. I was new here. This was my first time being in a foreign country for an extended period of time.
I think one of the hardest things for me was like senior year, I got really involved in the church politics, and it tore my church apart multiple times.
Before I came to InterVarsity, I was involved in my local church. We had a really nice youth group, it was very small, but I always felt like we weren't close enough.
I started going to church in sixth grade, and I went throughout middle school, but I stopped going after I entered high school.
And I felt like it was really fun hanging out with them, but there's a sense of intimacy that lacked.
I didn't have a very strong fellowship background growing up, and so I didn't really know exactly what Christian community meant.
Throughout high school, I would go maybe once or twice a year, you know, maybe you're cultural Christian.
I entered freshman year thinking that I didn't need anyone else.
Before I came to Duke, I didn't really know God at all. I didn't really know what Christianity was. Yeah, I guess I wasn't very interested, but then I came in and IB people were just, you know, right on my doorstep and were really welcoming, and they were the first people to just give me a smile, give me a hug, and say, yeah, come out to Bible study or something.
I actually didn't grow up with any religious background at all, but I met some really cool people my freshman year last year, and they told me that I should check out Ivy Large Group.
And just the feeling that I had when I walked in was amazing. The community, just how everyone was praising and how everyone was really inviting and nice to me.
I didn't feel forced or obligated to do anything. It was just a really good time to create community.
We always, you know, we say that we're a community of Christians and non-Christians trying to get to know Jesus better. That's the plain truth. There's a lot of people who've been in church all their lives, and plenty of people who have not. and plenty of people who are not Christian yet, but what we're all trying to do is get to know God better. And
at first it was a little weird for me, but like, I don't know, all the people there are so awesome and welcoming that, like, it didn't even really matter after a while. And, like every time that I went, they really emphasized, you know, like, oh, this is a group for anyone, believers, non-believers. And that really helped to get me comfortable.
Coming here was really eye-opening. It's actually the first Christian community that I was really a part of.
I think God kind of put my two small group leaders that year in the right place at the right time, and me as well, and kind of got me plugged into IV really early in the year.
Small group was a huge reason of why I joined InterVarsity, because it made me feel welcome. It made me feel like I was part of a family.
But then they asked me to go to one of the Bible studies. And it was small, and the leaders there asked me how I was, and not just in the way of like, oh, you're a new person, oh, I want to like get to know you because you're new, but it was like, hey, I care about you. That was when, I guess, like, I started thinking differently about InterVarsity.
Since I've been at college, you know, I look back, and it's just amazing to see how much I've changed, how much of a heart I've started to have for, you know, people in the city, like in Durham, people around the world. And then just for God.
People here are really passionate. There are people who are passionate about music, people who are passionate about sports, people who are passionate about academics. But I think most importantly, they're all passionate about God.
It's where I see God moving. He's just constantly moving through the people and in the people in the fellowship. I see God changing people's lives and pursuing people.
I was so amazed by IV because there's such a tight-knit group of people that I really, really love, who I can talk about anything with, and where it's like funny and like really amusing and at all times, and then suddenly we can talk about something so serious.
Well, through this genuine community, we have a lot of people who are passionately pursuing God, who He is, trying to show His love to others. So I think ultimately, I've really found God at IV.
I found what God, I almost am beginning to find what God is. I've never had that before. Before I came to college, every time I come to large group, every time I go to small group, I feel like I'm getting to know like a piece by piece bit of Him.
And so that's what IV's meant to me. Just to know Christ better through the body.
If I had to describe InterVarsity at Duke, I would describe it as a family away from home.
Island!